Hello, good evening to all the viewers who are watching live from their home. Yeah, we have been delayed with what, like 23 minutes due to some network issues. Our few of our panel members were facing, and we were also facing the same. So, without wasting any more time, let's just start today's CME with the same usual 30 seconds countdown. Enjoy.
Good evening, everybody. Good evening, Kalyani sir.
Good evening.
We are
Very
on the
good evening.
18th. We are on the 18th online CME session, and today we have two very important topics to discuss for every clinician. To start with the CME, with permission of our President Kalyani sir, I'd like to request Professor Dr. Pranab Polle, Head of the Department of Repertory, Bengal Homeopathic Medical College and Hospital, Asansol. Over to you, Dr. Pranab.
Good evening, everyone. My regards, respected teachers of NIH, seniors, and all viewers. Myself, Dr. Pranab Polle, second batch BHMS. Welcome to all in online CME live program on behalf of NIH Alumni Association. Today's topic is interpretation of mental rubric through AV presentation and need of repertory in every case, including keynote prescription. Both two topics is very practical one, and it will be helpful for beginners also. And though use repertory every day, they have any doubt, they can. It will be clear that we have today very eminent speakers, Dr. Ashok Kumar Rai, Professor HOD, Kharagpur Homeopathy Medical College. He is more than 25 years in the field of repertory. And we have another speaker, Dr. Shamiran Pal, Medical Officer, RBSK, the West Bengal, Government of West Bengal, and this program will coordinate by Dr. P.P. Kundu, Parthapratim Kundu, HOD, Professor, Bengal Homeopathy Medical College, in the Forensic Medicine. So now I will hand over this program will continue by Dr. Parthapratim Kundu. Okay, hand over.
Good evening. Thank you, Dr. Pranab, for your inaugural speech. And we are waiting for Professor Parthapratim Kundu, sir, to join, as we had been delayed by almost 20-25 minutes. Sir, with your due permission, can we start with Professor Dr. Ashok Kumar Rai?
Sure, sure. Let us start. We are already linked. Please start.
Okay, sir. Now, let us bring on Prof. Dr. Ashok Kumar Rai on the digital platform, who will be guiding us the need of repertory in every case, including keynotes prescription. Over to you, Ashok, sir.
Thank you, Vidut. Good evening, everyone. It's my pleasure to share, it's my pleasure and privilege to share my view with all the alumni of National Institute of Homeopathy and others. This topic, need of repertory in every cases, need of repertory in every cases, including keynote prescription, is very important topic. Why I am saying this, I will later discuss on. But before that, I want to say that till now, we are accustomed to listen that use repertory only when the cases are not clear cut. But it's very difficult to say that which case is clear cut. If you repertorize a case, then you will see that none of the cases are clear cut. Every case is there in need of repertory. And I choose this topic because generally people are discussing that this and that, why we shall, it is time taking, it is too much lengthy work, all these things. And some are dare to say that during reading or writing, can we use dictionary every time? It's my suggestion that if the meaning is not clear, then don't hesitate to use dictionary during reading or writing. If meaning is clear, then no need of dictionary. Same thing is here also. If you know all the symptoms, if you know the drugs against all the symptoms, then don't you may not use repertory. But if you are not know all the drugs against the required symptom, then it's my suggestion to must use the repertory. Otherwise, it will create problem. Many wonderful cures have been made without repertory previously. But remember that many wonderful failures followed these people. Many wonderful failures followed these people. So it's my suggestion to use repertory in every cases if you are think so. Why I am telling that use of repertory in every cases, I want to give you some examples. These examples will tell you that whether repertory is needed or not. Generally, we are giving much importance to mental symptom, and I want to start examples with mental symptom. One symptom very important to a patient, that fear of death. Patient is very important symptom, that fear of death. And this is mental symptom. We cannot leave this mental symptom. But tell me, how many drugs we know against the fear of death? As for my experience, and I asking someone else, maximum, if you start asking this fear of death, maximum will tell you two drugs. One is aconite and another is arsenic. Maximum, more than 75% people will tell you these two drugs, aconite and arsenic, there is fear of death. Well, but if the patient is thirstless, then what we can do at that time? Either we shall leave thirstless. No, this is physical symptom, not important on basis of mental symptom. We can prescribe either arsenic or aconite. Or we shall leave this mental symptom on basis of thirstless. With other symptom, we can prescribe the drug. This problem can be solved if you use the repertory. This problem very easily you can solve when you use the repertory. I am just telling you how many drugs against this fear of death in Kent repertory, highest grade, first grade drug. There are 9 first grade drugs are given in Kent repertory. I am not talking about synthesis, synthetic and modern repertory. I am talking about Kent repertory. Aconite, arsenic, calcarea, semicifuga, gelsemium, lecanium, nitric acid, platina, phosphorus. These are the first grade remedy carrying 3 marks. And we are busy with only aconite and arsenic. And these 9 drugs are first grade and almost 27 drugs second grade. See, just 3 times more than the first grade, 27 drugs second grade and same number of third grade medicine. So among the 50 remedies, we are choosing only 2, either aconite or arsenic. This is not fair. If we are accustomed to use repertory, then we can remember that there is gelsemium and thursless is there. There is pulsatilla in second grade and thursless is there. So we can very easily differentiate the drug and choose the correct remedy. Another symptom, from mental symptom, that in first year, second year, third year, whenever the disappointment of love arises, a smile in our faces, the disappointment of love. But how many drugs we know against this disappointment of love? Only Ignatia? Every time we shall prescribe Ignatia? Or some other drugs also? Just open the Kent repertory and see that hyoscyamus, Ignatia, Natremur, and acid. Strepsiagria are the second grade remedy and third grade remedies are also there. I am just telling about these 2 grades. So in our hand, in our quiver, so many remedies are there, but we remember only 1 or 2 and told everyone that these are sufficient enough to prescribe. We are prescribing very easily arsenic, aconite or Ignatia against these 2 symptoms and thinks that we are great practitioner, great prescriber, everything. So leave the ego, use the repertory. It is very helpful. Just I am giving another mental symptom, that fear of dog. Whenever the fear of dog symptoms arises, immediately our mind run toward the tuberculinum. Maximum of us going toward the tuberculinum. Is tuberculinum only drug where fear of drug is? Or we are biased enough to use tuberculinum against the fear of drug, fear of dog? I am going to tell you that which drug is highest grade in fear of dog. Belladonna and another drug is China. Until and unless I shall not use the repertory, I could not know that China has the highest grade in fear of dog. Another drugs. Causticum, hyoscyamus, stramonium, and tuberculinum. Tuberculinum is second grade remedy, not first grade remedy. But we are remembering tuberculinum and forget that belladonna and China as a first grade remedy against the fear of dog. The thousands and thousands this type of examples in repertory. I am not going to tell all the symptoms, just I had given showing you some examples. Bathing dread of, or fearful, or dread of bathing, one symptom is there. How many drugs we know against the bathing dread of? Only sulfur or some other drug also we know. So we shall choose every time when fear of bathing or dread of bathing is there, only sulfur all the time. It is not fair. Just open the repertory and see the drugs. Amoncarb Antim crude, Clematis, Sorinum, Rustrux, Cypia, Spizelia, Sulfur. These are highest grade drugs. About 8 to 9 drugs are there, but we are remembering only 1 or 2, either Antim crude or Sulfur or some other drugs, and think that it is enough. Our knowledge is much more knowledge. There is no need of repertory. Why I shall use every time repertory? So be careful. Our metria knowledge is also increased. Our differentiation shall be very nice when we take the help of repertory. One symptom we are using in almost acute cases or chronic cases, open air aggravation. How many drugs we know against the open air aggravation or open air amelioration? But if we use the repertory, there are number of drugs, open air aggravation and open air amelioration. Another, and this repertory not only give us maximum number of drugs, but also rectify ourselves, that rectify yourself, collect the right answer, collect the right symptoms. One symptom I am going telling, intense heat on the head and body cold. Intense heat on the head and body cold. We change the symptom according to the knowledge, our knowledge. Immediately after intense heat in the head and body cold, we think that arnica. But arnica have the different symptom, not this symptom. Arnica have the upper part of the body hot and lower part cold. Intense heat in head and body cold, that is arsenic is highest grade, carrying 3 marks. And other drugs are belladonna, opium, stramonium. Arnica is not present here, but we are just, because we know that arnica have upper part hot and lower part cold, so head is upper part, use arnica. If we use repertory, it can rectify us. Don't change the symptom. If you are keynote prescriber, you use that. I have no problem. Because one thing I know, that Rahul Dravid and Hardik Pandya both are important. If I want to change Rahul Dravid become Hardik Pandya and Hardik Pandya become Rahul Dravid, then it is useless. We can only rectify them. We can rectify Hardik Pandya, but not completely change. If you are keynote prescriber, you can use keynote. We have no problem. But check it with the help of repertory. You play like Hardik Pandya. All not become classical repertorian or classical batsman. You work according to your ability. I don't want to say here that you change yourself completely. You work according to your knowledge, but take the help of repertory even during keynote prescription. These I had given example from mental symptom, general symptom, now particular symptom. Very important. Pain in abdomen forced the patient to bend double, or he is compelled to bend double. How many drugs in our quiver? Only colocin or macfos, or some other drugs are there. With that patient is giving a symptom that there is history of, there is, sorry, causative factor is he had attended a marriage party previous night. Now, as he had attended a marriage party, we shall sift our choice either from Nux Vomica or Pulsatilla or some other drug. What about the main symptom, bending double amelioration? If you open the repertory, you can get that Pulsatilla is the dear drug. And you can prescribe that Pulsatilla very easily. Another particular symptoms are involuntary urination, coughing during. We are accustomed with using causticum against this symptom. Here again, I want to say that only causticum or some other drugs are also. If you forced your memory, then you can get one or two more drugs. But if you open the repertory, their maximum drugs are there. Epis, causticum, Pulsatilla, Natramur, Esquila, these are the highest grade drugs. Alumina, Belladonna, Bryonia, Capsicum, Cinchona, Colchicum, Ferumfos, Creosote, Lycopodium, Nux Vomica, Phosphoric Acid, Reumex, Cipia, second grade remedy. So many drugs are there, but we are biased enough to use only one or two, either causticum or some other drugs, Natramur. Use repertory. You can enjoy it. It's my suggestion. Another symptom, particular symptom, pain in knee joint. Pain in knee joint on beginning to move. Whenever patient start moving, at that time pain aggravated. What is the drug? Rustax. Yes, you are quite right. Rustax is the drug.
Mm-hmm.
But in here, the patient is thirstless. We know that Rustax is thirsty. Here, the patient is thirstless. What we can do? After knowing the second symptom, can we prescribe the Rustax? Oh, forget it. Rustax works here very nicely. Give Rustax. No, sir. Take the help of repertory. And in repertory there, Pulsatilla have also the same symptoms. On beginning to move, there is aggravation and amelioration by continued motion and thirstless. Pain in teeth. Very short case, it is acute case. Pain in teeth aggravated during thunderstorm. And another symptom with that, this pain is extended from teeth to ear. Against the pain, we may know that rhododendron is there. During thunderstorm or before thunderstorm, that rhododendron. But this pain extended from teeth to ear, we don't know which drug is there. So if we prescribe rhododendron, it may act or may not act. But if it not work, within few hours, we can change the drug. But if we see that pain from teeth extend up to ear, rhododendron is also there, then we can more sure, and we can wait for that. If patient after 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half hour, 1 hour, tell that there is still no amelioration, our suggestion is to wait and watch. This drug is quite right. If we take the help of repertory, then we shall get one confident. And once the medicine starts work, and if we change, then according to Dr. Kent, it is criminal activity. Choose the correct drug and give sufficient time to work there. If we are not, generally we change the drug because we are not confident. On basis of one or two drugs against a symptom, we are prescribing that one or two drugs and want to get result. If positive result is not there, then immediately we shall shift it to the, some other drugs. And these shifting jeopardize total, completely jeopardize homeopathy and homeopathic cure. So it's once again my suggestion to take the help of repertory always. Generally, when patient comes to our chamber, at that time, we start case taking, observation and case taking, both are started there. And almost every time, we are telling our patient to show me your tongue. Ask yourself, how many tongue we know? Only Marcel, Rustus, Antimcrude, Natramure, Ipecac, or some other trunks are also there. Suppose that one person is showing you that green tongue. It is not in our knowledge. Green tongue, how rare, uncommon, peculiar symptom is that green tongue is there. What we can do? We can go to the Materia Medica and read every drug. Which drug have green tongue? It's not easy to take the help of repertory. Open the repertory, mouth chapter, discoloration, tongue green. Only 2-3 drugs are there and you can use that drug. Natrum sulf, highest grade. Nitric acid, plumbum, rhododendron. These are the green tongue. Likewise, brown tongue, white-coated tongue. When question arises, white-coated tongue, immediately Antimcrude comes in our mind. But against Antimcrude, thickly white-coated tongue is there. Thickly milky white-coated tongue, not only white-coated tongue. Against white-coated tongue, there are 12 drugs. 12 drugs. How many drugs we know? Against white-coated. Red tip of the tongue. Red tip of the tongue. Whenever red tip of the tongue arises, Rustax comes in our mind, red tip of the tongue, triangular red tip of the tongue. We change it in triangular red tip of the, it is not triangular red tip, it is tip of the tongue is red. Arsenic, argentum, phyto, rustax, rustvein, sulfur is the drug. So many drugs are there, but our mind remember only rustax, red tip of the tongue, and we are telling that we are prescribing the correct remedy, classical prescribing, and all using all the adjective against our prescription. And telling that it is clear-cut case, patient is thirsty, red tip of the tongue, motion aggravation, so we can use Rustax. I had given examples, if you open the repertory, thousands and thousands this type of examples are there. And it's my suggestion that use repertory. Even sure, when you are sure that I know the remedy, I know all the remedy, you can use repertory. Another, people are giving that, it is too much time taking. Here I also want to say that, if we spend some more time for correct prescription, is it wrong? I hope that it is the right way to take the help of repertory. But what we are doing when a new patient came to our chamber without repertory, what you are doing? We are doing the case taking. We analyze the case and evaluation. Erecting the totality. Consulting Materia Medica and prescription after that. So these five steps we shall follow in every case. First, case taking, analysis and evaluation, erecting totality, consulting Materia Medica and prescription without the repertory. And what we are doing with the repertory? Same, these steps we are case taking, analysis and evaluation, erecting totality, selection of repertory, rubric conversion, repertorization proper, analysis of the repertorial results. And same the prescription with the help of consulting Materia Medica. We know that while we are doing the case taking, if case taking is good, then 75% work is over. So we shall work hard for that 75% work, and other works are only 25%. If we can work hard for 75% work, why we shall be afraid for other 25% work? Among other that, erecting totality, up to the erecting totality, we are doing always with or without repertory. And this erecting totality is very funny thing. If you know the drug, you can do the totality very easily. If you don't know, then you shall wait. More symptoms, you need it. But in every cases, I shall request you to use repertory. After listening all these examples, I think that you are also start saying that repertory is needed in every case. Some are says that repertory have less number of no shots. So no shots are not coming while we are using the Kent repertory. If you think that this case is moving toward no shots, then take the help of modern repertory. There are good number of no shots are there. Or still there is lack of no shots, then prepare another repertory. Where you try to use the no shots. But don't tell that these are the reason why I shall not use repertory. If you use the repertory and repertorization, then you have one ready-made answer for second prescription. You can very easily do second prescription, but still we are saying that there is no need of repertory. Now you can decide. You want yourself a homeopath or want to keep yourself those who prescribed aconite for fever, colocin for colic, and arsenic for chill. Being a homeopath, we shall prescribe drugs on basis of totality, not on basis of one or two symptoms. If only one or two symptoms are present, then we shall, in that case, also try to choose the repertory. And repertory will guide us now what next we shall ask them. I want to give you another case. where some other drugs are coming. One case is here, I am saying you, that pain in left shoulder aggravated lying on painful side. Pain in left shoulder aggravated lying on painful side. And with that, other mental symptom is there, disappointment of love, fear of death, thirstless, warm food desire, desire for fruit, thermal reaction, chilly patient, and patient is very weak feeling is there. So many symptoms are there. Can we prescribe any drug against this? Again, I am repeating it. Pain in left shoulder, aggravated lying on painful side, fear of death, thirstless, disappointed love, food desire, warm food desire, desire for fruit, thermal reaction, chilly patient. If you are able to say the drugs, then all right. But from where you shall get the confidence that drug is correct or not? So take the help of repertory. How many drugs we shall read in Materia Medica to search these symptoms? Now just start. I'm giving you this. Drug is acid phos. Drug is acid phos covering all the symptoms. Covering all the symptoms. Drug is acid phos. And I shall able to prescribe this only because I use the repertory. If I shall not use repertory, then either I shall prescribe on basis of fruit desire, thirstless China is the drug, or some thirstless pulsatilla is the drug, or pain in left shoulder aggravated lying on painful side, lying on painful side. On basis of that, we can prescribe a drug. And if the patient says that there is no amelioration, immediately we shall change drug haphazardly here and there. We shall use so many drugs, and at last probably acid phos will come or not, I don't know. So once again, it's my suggestion to use repertory in all the cases. We are late. One very young and energetic speaker is waiting here. So I am requesting you once again to use repertory in every case. Hope that these examples can force you to use repertory. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Ashok Kumar Rai, sir, for your vibrant speech and without any presentation. Always comes from thorough, in-depth knowledge. We had learned a lot of things. I think we have with us our moderator, Professor Partha Pratim Kundu, sir. Kalyani, sir, your inputs, please.
Very nice. Many, many thanks to Professor Dr. Ashok Kumar Rai. Nice presentation. I had a listening in early life that if you put Ganges water in a bottle, within a very short time, by depositing the crystals of the Ganges water, it looks like a transparent water, drinking water. The essence and the beauty and the respect of Ganges water goes off. And if you shake the bottle once, again the bottle, transparent water, becomes Ganges water, and respect, all our faith, everything comes on Ganga water. So this seminar today by Ashok Rai became that type of things. We are, by practicing, by service in regular practices, we are gradually avoiding repertories. That is simply shaking of our knowledge, that repertory is a must for every prescription. keynote prescription is simply trial and error. It is a futile and suicidal attempt for beginners who will start keynote prescription, I can tell you. To those who have seen keynote prescription successful, they are obviously very much knowledgeable person regarding repertory. They have in-depth repertory knowledge. Then only they become keynote prescriber, what you have seen. But simply keynote prescription is simply a trial. It never gives you confidence regarding cure and selection of the drug. So please listen to Dr. Rai. Do not forget to consult repertory if you want to be a confident and confirmed prescriber. Otherwise, we are going to be gradually weak and weak and weak. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Rai. Many thanks. Next speaker, please.
Thank you, sir. We'll request Dr. Pranav Polle also to take over as a moderator. So we are trying to connect Dr. Partha Pratim Kundu. I'll request backstage editor to bring upon our next speaker, Dr. Shomiran Pal. Over to you, Dr. Shomiran Pal.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, yes, you are audible. Good evening.
Good evening, Dr. Kolani, sir.
Good evening, Dr.
Mukherjee. Good evening, Dr. Ashok Rai. Good evening, Dr. Pranav Polle. And good evening, Dr. Partha Pratim Kundu and all the audience. Let me introduce myself. I am Dr. Shomiran Pal. I am 13 batch UG and 14 batch PG from National Institute of Homeopathy. I was formerly attached with MMH, MCH, Katiyar as assistant professor. And recently, I am working as medical officer of Government of West Bengal. First of all, very good evening to all of you. And because it is my first seminar, happy new year to all of you. So today I am going to present a very interesting topic that is a very, very practical topic. That is the interpretation of the mental rubric. Okay, so that is very interesting. The session is going to be very, very interesting. Dr. Rai already, as per the lecture of the Dr. Rai, it is clear to us that it is extremely important, to consider and to discuss and to refer with the repertory or the repertories. Okay, so that is extremely important. But along with another the problem arises, that is the connection with the and the connection with the mind, the psychiatric symptoms. And almost we can say that each and every homeopathic medicine is basically concerned with the mind symptoms, and each and every medicine can be considered as a psychiatric medicine. So in that context, if we can understand or interpret the mind symptoms, so automatically we can convert it into the rubrics and we can consult the repertory. So the problem is not that the patient is not going to give you any symptom. Okay, so patients are going to give us many symptoms, but the problem is due to lack of our knowledge and due to lack of our interpretation power, we are not able to correlate or to convert the symptom into the rubrics. Okay, so that is the main problem. So today we are going to discuss in detail with the audiovisual presentation. So let me start with my the PowerPoint presentation. Is it visible to everyone? Is it visible to everyone? Please.
Yes, it's visible. Just click on the hide button.
Okay,
take over, sir.
Okay, thank you, Orko. So let us start our very interesting journey. It is basically a new approach because we usually discuss repertory many times, but today we are going to discuss in a different approach with the help of the silver screens. Because so many interesting the symptoms, the mental symptoms are there, which can be converted into rubrics with the help of these the video clippings. And these are extremely interesting and it will be very easy to understand or to interpret the mental symptoms into the mental rubrics. Okay. So today I am going to dedicate this seminar to our sir, Dr. M.M. Dutta sir. Okay, he is no more with us, but his training and teaching will always remain with us. And also to the corona warriors all over the world. Okay, and the families who have lost their lives. Okay, in this pandemic situation. So okay, let's start without wasting. Okay, let's start the different the concept and the thoughts. Okay, as per the different stalwarts. Okay. As per our father, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, mind is the key to the man. And we all know that the mental symptoms is extremely important whenever we are considering the repertories. Okay, so if we know the mind symptoms, okay, our activity, our prescription is going to be very, very easy and very, very effective. As per Dr. Kent, okay, Dr. Kent says he must know just how every remedy affects mankind in the memory and understanding. As per Bogar, if physician can get at the patient's mode of thinking, his involuntary ideas, he can build up a picture of his mental process. And as per Freud, the mind is like an iceberg. It floats with 1/7 of its bulk above water. So basically, we can say that the importance of the mind is extremely on our the different prescription, because nowadays we can say that the psychosomatic disorder or the somatopsychic disorders, and the mental symptoms, if we take properly, if we can consider properly, it will be extremely helpful for the prescription. Okay, and we can say that it may also be helpful in case of the different psychiatric illness, in case of the different physical illness. Not only that, the different peculiar in order to select the different peculiar the characters, the striking peculiarities of the mental generalities. Okay, so that can also be considered and can also be interpreted and can also be converted into the mental rubrics. Okay. Now the question arises. The question may arise. Okay, so why silver skin? Okay, so why we are taking the silver skin? Okay, so many doctor or many students may ask, why we are taking the help of the silver skin? Okay, we are taking the help of the silver skin because the plenty of characters and events are already available. Okay, the characters from the different cinema and the video represent the respective rubrics. Okay, so that is very important, and it is obviously very easy to understand and moreover very, very interesting. Okay, so that is why we have considered the silver skin, the different the video clipping from the different movies. Okay, different movies. Okay, the clippings. Okay, our approach is very simple. Our approach is we are going to show you very small clipping of 1 to 2 minutes. Okay, and within that time, if you can able to understand that, if you can guess the rubric, you can please comment on the comment box. Okay, so definitely we are going to do this in an interactive manner. And simultaneously, you can think in your mind that which rubric may come. Okay, in this context or in this video. Okay, so that is very important, and the different rubrics are represented by the different characters. Okay, the characters already the playing the role are the different characters. Okay, so without wasting, so we are going to show you the seven the videos, the seven clippings one by one. Okay, let's start. So we are going to play the first video. It is a very common and very, very popular movie. Okay, so let's have the clipping and let us try to understand the interpretation. Okay, so what is the mental state and how we can convert this the mentality or the mind symptom into the mental rubrics. Okay.
Kya boss? Apun ko laga apun ki dosti ho gayi hai. Koi lafda nahi. Tu abhi tak coolness mein. Problem kya hai?
Problem aap hai Mr. Sharma. Hame apne college mein discipline chahiye, cabre nahi.
Kya discipline ko pakad ke rota rehta hai? Ha? Wo zahir bechara mar raha hai. Apun ne usko thoda smile karaya bas. Are jaante na in logon ko. Khatam karna yaar.
Exactly. Khatam kar de. Now that you have accepted, congratulations. ये आपका रस्टिकेशन लेटर, कल तुम और तुम्हारा सामान कॉलेज से बाहर हो।
क्या तेरा बैड लक है यार, अभी 5 मिनट पहले अपुन यहाँ से कल्टी होने वाला था, लेकिन किसी ने अपना हाथ पकड़ा और बोला यहाँ से जाने का नहीं। अभी तेरे को जो उखाड़ने का उखाड़ ले, अपुन यहाँ से नहीं जाएगा।
अगर तुम नहीं गए तो पुलिस तुम्हें कैंपस से बाहर कर देगी।
पुलिस? पुलिस आज तक अपुन को अंदर नहीं कर सकी तो बाहर कहां से करेगी?
तुम जाओगे मिस्टर शर्मा।
ओके, अगर पुलिस अपुन को आगे के दरवाजे से बाहर करेगी तो अपुन पिछू के दरवाजे से अंदर आ जाएगी, लेकिन अपुन जाएगा नहीं। हा? टेंशन नहीं लेने का, अब तू देख अपुन क्या करता है।
So this is the character from a very popular okay movie, and this type of the characters okay having the bold resistance to an opposing force or authority okay that is the basic nature of the individual to defy normal rules, regulation and warnings. Not only that, they only do whatever they think is best irrespective of what others say. Okay, so probably you have guessed the okay rubric. Okay, yes, It is none other than defiant. Okay, defiant is the rubric. Okay, so correctly suits with the Munna Bhai character, and we can interpret the other cross references. For example, the either audacity, obstinate, courageous, insolence, etc. Okay, not only that, these are the different diseases. For example, the antisocial personality disorder, it can be mania, it can be schizophrenia. Okay, this kind of the mentality can be seen, and these are the different. The important drugs including arnica causticum, sina lycopodium, naxdomica, and many other drugs are there. Okay, so let's continue with the second the video clipping. That is also another very interesting one. Okay, let's have a look.
Large. ये मैं क्या सुन रहा हूँ बेटे? तुम्हारी हरकतों से तंग आकर सोनम तुम्हें डिवोर्स देना चाहती है, लेकिन तुम तो उसे प्यार करते हो, तुम मुझे अपना गुरु समझते हो, तुमने ऐसा क्यों किया बेटे?
ये सब तुम्हारी वजह से हुआ बड़ाऊ, और तुम मुझे को कोस रहे हो
बड़ाऊ?
हाँ बड़ाऊ, बेटी को पाला पोसा बंगले के अंदर, और उसके बाद शादी के बाद सड़ने के लिए छोड़ दिया सारा चाल के अंदर। हाँ अरे वो तो कम अकल थी, लेकिन तुमको तो अकल थी, तुम रोक सकते थे उसको, लेकिन नहीं, मैंने तुमको अपना गुरु माना, और तुमने क्या किया मेरे साथ? गुरुद्वारे के बाहर हाथ में कटोरा देकर भिखारी बनाकर खड़ा कर दिया मुझे, और बोले बेटा मांग भी। बड़े दामाद को देवी चलाने के लिए कंपनी, और मुझे क्या दिया? सोशल सर्विस सेंटर, कहां गरीबों की दुआ लगेगी? मेरी पत्तुआ का डर नहीं लगा तुझे बुड्ढे? बड़ी बेटी की शादी के बाद रिटायर नहीं हुआ, लेकिन मेरी शादी करते रिटायर होकर भिंडी और आलू उगाने के लिए चला गया गांव के अंदर। और याद है किस तरह से पीठ पर हाथ मारकर मुझसे कहा? हाँ कि बेटे आई एम प्राउड ऑफ यू माय सन, आई एम प्राउड ऑफ यू। मेरी बेटी खाली हाथ घर से जा रही है। अरे यार जब बच्ची के हाथ में कुछ दोगे नहीं तो खाली हाथ ही जाएगी घर से? इतना भी नहीं कि महीने दो महीने का खर्चा दे देते, लेकिन ना कहा कि मेरी सारी चिंता दूर होगी। अरे अपनी चिंता जब दूसरों को दे दोगे तो खुद की चिंता तो दूर हो जाएगी ना। दो तो बेटी पैदा कर सकते हो, दो घर दबा नहीं पाल सकते ना।
ओके, सो दैट वाज द सेकंड वीडियो। ओके, एंड वी कैन कंक्लूड एज द इम्प्यूडेंस और इम्पर्टेंट, प्राउड और ओवरबियरिंग treatment to others. Okay, that is the basic temperament of this kind of persons, and the persons lack respect for others. Okay, so and we can also conclude that it is a very rude temperament and the rude personality and the ill-mannered even to his elder or superiors. Okay, so these are the characters where the person is okay, so doing the conversation with his father-in-law, and he is also a very eminent lawyer of the city, but the fact is he is doing the extremely rude behavior with him. Okay, so okay, obviously we can understand that we can conclude as the insolent. Okay, insolent is the appropriate rubric for this kind of temperament or this kind of the mind symptom, and we can compare the cross references as the rudeness, audacity, contemptuous, defiant, haughty, etc., and the different diseases which may be associated. Okay, for example, the personality disorder or schizophrenia, and some drugs are available on the screen, okay, including cantharides, graphitis, hyoscyamus, and so many drugs are already there in the different repertories. Okay, next moving towards the third clipping. Okay, have a look. Okay,
what is it?
Penis. London.
ये बुक क्या है वानी?
मेरा सपना, मैं दुनिया का कोना कोना देखना चाहता हूँ।
पूरी जिंदगी निकल जाएगी ये सब करने में, बाकी सब कब करोगे?
बाकी सब क्या, 22 तक पढ़ाई, 25 पे नौकरी, 26 पे छोकरी, 30 पे बच्चे, 60 पे रिटायरमेंट और फिर मौत का इंतजार। ऐसी किसी पे लाइफ थोड़ी जीना चाहता हूँ।
तो फिर तुम क्या चाहते हो लाइफ से बनी?
रफ्तार, पागलपन, हर दिन इतना धमाकेदार होना कि मुझे अपनी दिल की धड़कनें अपने कानों तक सुनाई दे। मैं उड़ना चाहता हूं नैना, दौड़ना चाहता हूं, गिरना भी चाहता हूं, बस रुकना नहीं चाहता। जैसे कि ये पहाड़ चढ़ना तुम्हारे लिए शायद ये सिर्फ ट्रैकिंग, मेरे लिए नशा है।
ओके, सो दिस इज अ कैरेक्टर, वी नो दिस इज द कैरेक्टर, ओके, विद डिजायर टू ट्रैवल। These are the personalities with extreme fond or very fond of visiting new places and meeting new people and exploring, always try to explore the new places and the new destinations. Okay, and you have rightly guessed that is the rubric is none other than the cosmopolitan. Cosmopolitan is the correct rubric for this the symptom, this kind of the temperament and the mentality. And what are the different causes of problems? We can see there is a travel desire to or wonder desire to, and the disease is connected with the mainly the mania, different type of the manias, and the drugs may be associated with the calcarea falls, iodine tuberculum, and so many other diseases found in the different repertories. Okay, let's have another very interesting clipping, that is the clipping 4. Okay, that is also very popular and very interesting clipping. Okay, let's have. Okay.
भाई साहब ये जरा एड्रेस बताइए। भाई साहब ये पता बता सकते हैं आप?
आपकी शादी हुई है?
हाँ हुई है।
आपकी बीवी कैसी है?
अच्छी है, इसीलिए तो शादी की है।
घर में बच्चे हैं?
नहीं है।
घर में टीवी है?
हाँ है।
चलता है? जी टीवी है? स्टार कनेक्शन है?
हाँ है।
केबल है? कितना पिक्चर दिखाते हैं?
2 पिक्चर बताते हैं।
तीन क्यों नहीं दिखाते?
अरे 3 नहीं बताते हैं।
ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट की कलर है?
ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट है।
तो कलर क्यों नहीं लिया?
अरे मेरी मर्जी की बात है। कौन है?
आपकी मर्जी से मतलब?
अरे ये कौन है भाई आप?
तुम कौन हो?
मैं भूल गया हूँ।
घर में बिल्ली है?
नहीं है।
कुत्ता है?
है।
चारपाई पे खटमल है?
नहीं है।
दीवार पे चिपकली है?
है।
नारे की मादा है?
ठीक से देखा नहीं।
That's so funny, but this kind of characters are already available nearby us, okay? And the personalities are unduly curious about the affairs of others and extremely eager to learn and extremely eager to ask, okay? And always praying into others people, okay? This kind of the personalities are already available in our localities, in our school, colleges, in our offices, in our clubs, okay? These are the very, very common characters, okay? And they are apt to ask too many questions, even though it has no bearing to him. Okay, that is extremely important. And obviously, we can conclude that the rubric can be inquisitive. Inquisitive is the correct rubric. Okay, it suits with the particular personality. And what are the cross references? Okay, so let's have a look. That is curious, ask questions, many indiscretion, and so many other rubrics are also available as the cross references. The persons may suffer from the personality disorder or the anxiety disorders, and the different drugs are available, that is agaricus, lacasis, and others. Let's have our next presentation, that is our 5th clipping, that is also very interesting, and we are going to convert the mental symptom into the rubrics. Okay, let's have a look to the okay. So these are the personalities with very casual approach towards life. Okay, extremely casual they are, and acting hastily and incautiously. Okay, not only that, they are not worried about the consequences. Okay, that is very problematic. Okay, they are extremely casual. They act on their instincts. Okay, they act act on their instinct, and that is why they usually face many problems in their life, but they are also having the very casual approach towards that. And we can rightly guess that it is none other than the rashness. Okay, rashness can be the correct rubric for this type of personalities or the type of the mental symptoms. Okay. And what are the cross references we can observe? That is the abrupt or careless or heedless, etc. This can be the different cross reference. Okay, the rubrics. And the diseases may be connected with, that is the different type of the manias and the personality disorder and the schizophrenia. The drugs which may be associated, that is the Orum and the capsicum, the pulsatil, and so many other drugs. Okay. Next, the next clipping. Okay, if you can guess, please comment, suggest your rubrics on the comment section. Okay, because we are doing the question answer and the interactive manner. You can comment your guess rubric on the comment section. Okay, so next okay, video clipping. That is the video clipping 6. Okay, let's have a look.
ये क्या करिए मिसेस ब्रिगेंजा, आप इतने सालों से घर के गवर्नर्स हैं, इनको चाय पिलाने का तरीका देखो विराटी आपने
कुछ नहीं मिस्टर दर्शन, मामूली सी बात है, मैं अभी चेंज कर।
ये मामूली सी बात है? अरे इस मामूली सी बात की वजह से मेरे घर में आग लग सकती थी।
आग? कमाल है, चाय यहाँ गिरी और आपके घर में आग कैसे लग सकती?
अरे सिंपल सा लॉजिक है, चाय यहाँ गिरी ना, यहाँ गिरती तो दाग पड़ जाता और ये दाग लेके मैं घर जाता। मेरी बीवी अंधेरे में लिपस्टिक का दाग समझ के मुझ पर शक करती, मुझसे झगड़ा करती, वो ये समझती कि मेरा किसी लड़की के साथ चक्कर है और खुदकुशी करने की कोशिश करती, घासे डाल के खुद को जलाती, खुद भी जलती और घर को जला देती।
लेकिन दर्शन भैया, आप तो अभी कमा रहे हैं, आपकी शादी कहाँ हुई?
शादी हो गई होती तो घर ही जलता। बात करते हैं आप क्यों जी?
क्या बात है दर्शन, किसके घर के जलने की बात कर रहे हो तुम?
अरे कुछ नहीं राज भैया, एक्चुअली मैं इनको लॉजिक समझा रहा था, अगर फिर भी ये लोग नहीं समझे तो देखना इस घर में एक दिन बाढ़ आ सकती है, और ये मत पूछना कैसे।
मेरा दिमाग खराब हो गया जो तुमसे पूछूंगा।
पूछ के देखिए, अगर बाढ़ नहीं आए तो बोलना।
ओके, प्रॉब्ली यू हैव गेस्ड द रूब्रिक। दिस काइंड ऑफ पर्सनालिटीज आर हैविंग वेरी इमेजिनेटिव एंड लेस प्रैक्टिकल पर्सन्स। ओके, दीज आर वेरी वेरी लेस प्रैक्टिकल, नॉट ओनली दैट दे आर वेरी वेरी the visionary. Okay, it may or may not be present in the real life, and they usually build castles in the air. And you have rightly guessed that it is none other than the air castles. Okay, that is the correct rubric for this kind of the individuals. Okay, and the cross references are theorizing or daydreaming, and so many other rubrics are also available. The diseases may be connected, personality disorder, schizophrenia. And the drugs may be associated with the Orum, and so many other rubrics are also available in the repertories. Okay, our last but not the least, that is our the last clipping of tonight presentation, that is the video clipping number 7. Okay, let's have a look. Okay, so this is a case of the delusions. We can clearly say that, and it is defined as the fixed false beliefs that conflict with the reality. Not only that, despite the contrary evidence, the person in delusional state can't let go their convictions. Okay, that is very problematic. Okay, that is why we can take the rubric delusions for this kind of the mentality or the mind symptoms. And the cross references can be the crazy, ideas fixed, and so many other rubrics are also available. Disease may be associated, that is either schizophrenia, mania, and the different drugs which are available, that is argentinitinga, belladonna, and so many other drugs are in the repertoire. So we have the probably it is completely clear to the new practitioner or the students, as well as to many of us, that what is the meaning and the inner meaning and the exact presentation of the particular character, the character of the symptoms. Okay, that is very very clear, and that is why we can conclude that it is basically a new approach. I have tried a different approach for your interpretation, for your understanding. Okay, I may have done some mistake, please forgive me, but if you have liked this, please comment in the comments section so that we can present some more this kind of the presentation and the this kind of the interpretation, okay, where the different rubrics can be very much similar to each other, okay, how we can differentiate between them, okay, the rubrics which are completely opposite to each other, which are very much nearer to each other, how we can distinguish between two, and it will be a crystal clear, the concept will be completely crystal clear. It is obviously a better discussion, the better mode of discussion, because we all know that the audiovisual approach, audiovisual the training and the teaching and understanding, that is the best mode. It is going to give you the best impact in our mind. Okay, so that is why it is the best way of discussion as well as the best way of understanding. And not only that, it is going to create our the outstanding clinical eye, and which is very important. And Dr. Rai, our the previous speaker, okay, he has correctly said that it is absolutely important to consider the repertory, okay, because I am a the PG student, I was the PG student of the repertory and the case taking. That is why I can say that the repertory is going to give you so many suggestions, and you can choose your option from the correct option from the different alternatives, okay. And that is why we need to develop our clinical eye, because we should not go for the guesses, okay. If already there are so many alternatives, we should take the help of the repertories, and this kind of the mental rubrics, obviously we are going to enhance our knowledge as well as our the presentation, as well as our the depth and the clinical eye is going to be very, very clear, okay. So if you like, we can definitely in future, we will try some this kind of the presentation in future, okay. So today I'm concluding my presentation. Thank you all of you. Thank you Dr. Bridhun Mukherjee, our beloved senior dada, and the alumni association for giving me the opportunity so today evening for inviting me as well as to present this seminar, okay. So thank you all of you. Thank you all. Over to you, Arko.
Thank you, Dr. Sharmiran. It's a very new and very innovative approach, and this sort of approaches only happens in NIH. What do you say, Kalyani sir?
Definitely, you are very correct. Many, many thanks, Sharmiran. Your thank seminar you. Today reminded me the period of 1974 to 1981 of Calcutta Homeopathic Medical College and NIH. I want to add my few experiences. Many, many thanks. This type of approach. During our time, on that phase, I am telling, latter phase of 1970s, those teachers were very much famous in Calcutta and all over India. Those used to teach Mathematica in dramatic manners. I'll give you a few examples. Means it was an approach to indent symptom in the student's mind in such a manner the student will never, never forget. Intensity of the symptom, importance of the symptom, to make students understand and keep it in mind forever, that was the nice approach. And the master was well-known named Dr. S.K. Dubey. You'll be surprised to know he was gold medalist in anatomy. When I entered in Calcutta Homeopathy College in 1974, he was head of the Department of Anatomy. He used to teach anatomy with pant and shirt as our teacher, anatomy teacher. He used to come always with pant and shirt. First year, second year anatomy. On third year, suddenly found the same person has come in the class with complete white dresses, Punjabi and dhoti and chappal, a typical Bengali figure. Now we were surprised how anatomy teacher can teach Mathematica. He started teaching Mathematica, and the first day he told, "See, my friends, I am a student of this institution. I will not allow anybody to be without Ellen's keynote in hand inside the campus of Calcutta Homeopathy Medical College. I will kick him out. I have that power. Be careful. If you don't have Ellen's keynote, do not come before me. I should not see you. I am teacher of anatomy. Anatomy is in my brain, but Mathematica is in my heart. I love Mathematica in such a manner." And he used to teach Mathematica every symptom of a drug in completely dramatical manner with that dhoti and sari, dhoti and Punjabi. each symptom by caricatures, by changing his facial appearances, by hands, by standing, by moving, by what not. In every manner, he will make the symptoms realize by your mind, and never since then, the teachings of Dr. S.K. Dubey, my respected teacher, I, not only myself, nobody, none of us could ever forget that symptom and importance of the symptom. So we have experience. I am very, very thanks. Many, many thanks to Samiran that the things has again crop up. Bidu is having nice experience of making drama in NIH by drugs, character of drugs. Our teachers, especially Dr. S.K. Dubey, Dr. M.M. Singh, Dr. P.C. Pal, Mahendra Singh means father of present director, Dr. Subhash Singh. They used to tell us, if you want to enrich your knowledge, especially mental symptom, then simply go on observing persons not by name, but by drugs. When you are traveling in the train, when you are sitting somewhere, traveling in the bus, going to the market, everywhere, try to find out what drug he is. Eric Sawal, what drug he is. A Patol Sabjiwala, he is talking, interexchanging. What drug he may be. So that was our teaching, that try to see every person around yourself as a mathematical drug. Then mathematics will be easier, soothing, sweet, and you will never, never forget symptoms of Mathematica. So this dramatic approach of symptoms, Mathematica and repertory is a very, very nice approach that I have experienced. And very nice that Samiran has started. I must request him to enrich these type of things gradually. Nice presentation. It seems to be good, easy to realize, and very nice approach to remember forever. Thank you very much. Many, many thanks. He said, it is in. I must tell you that this is the biggest international emeritus homeopathic platform of the world. You must agree. So here we must present some new things, innovative things, beautiful things, new approaches by which every one of us will be enriched by our knowledge and confidence. Thank you. Thank you very much to all. Nidhu, please.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, because we learned from NIH how to memorize, how to visualize Maitreya Medica with our drug drama quiz program through and thorough. And even that had been propagated even in a VID homeopathic medical college. Once I was in Maharashtra on my professional tour in their few of the colleges where even our present director was a student over there during his PG courses. We had several sessions, what the NIH people are doing. Dr. Uttarasya Pachegaokar, Dr. Bhasme and all, they were very eager to know what NIH has been doing. And we all got this from Professor S.K. Bhattacharya, from you, sir, Dr. P.K. Mishra, Dr. Sunirmal Sarkar, Dr. L.M. Khan, Dr. S.Z. Khan, and so many other teachers, all the emeritus teachers who had been associated with NIH and who had been teaching us. But today, my partner during that crying days for drug drama quiz was Dr. Pralay Sharma. Dr. Partha Pratim, he is now a professor, Partha Pratim Roy from Maharashtra. So, I am really indebted to Samiran that a new concept had come over. After so many years, I am feeling proud again that being an alumni of NIH and another alumni of NIH is doing something great. Kudos to Samiran. I think if Pralay is in, he would also have been proud if Dr. Pralay Sharma is in here. Now we have with us Dr. Pranab Polle. Dr. Pranab, if you can put your video on. As Dr. Partha Pratim Kundu was unable to connect due to his poor network connection, he had requested over telephone to take over the moderator charge. For Dr. Pranab Polle. Dr. Pranab, please contact if there is any question and answer and your views on the total session. Dr. Pranav, if you can hear us.
Yeah. Hello.
Pranav, over to you.
Yes. Yes.
No, sir, what to you, sir? You just continue the session. Yes, you are audible clearly, sir. Sir, I think while inserting the headphone, you are unable to hear.
Is there a question regarding this topic?
Sir, some kind of sound coming, like a bell ring type.
Oh.
Sir, let me just tell you, there is no question till now.
Sir, please continue.
Please.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. So, host, please take over.
Yeah, there has been network problem with Professor Pranav also. Now, the appeal which we used to do and. On a regular basis, it has been done by Dr. Pralay Sharma, your beloved Pralay sir, about the benevolent fund. We had been trying to generate a benevolent fund to help the alumni in need. Like few weeks, few months back, we had lost few of our alumni, and we had been trying to reach their families with some minimal, though it might be minimal, but with some contribution. So we request all the alumni who are watching and will be watching in the future in the YouTube channel, please come forward, be generous, and whatever amount you can, please do contribute on the bank account number given in the narration as well as in the alumni group or WhatsApp group. We also started with our Telegram group, and we had been appealing and approaching all the alumni across the globe to contribute, come forward in a generous manner. We have a very minimal annual contribution to run the alumni association. Per alumni has to pay 100 rupees as an annual subscription. So please come forward, be generous, and contribute. We had been able to help two of our beloved alumni who had left us in last year with a contribution of 50,000 each. So please come forward and enable us to be in touch with all the alumni. So far, so we have so many batches of dipenage, 13 batches, I presume. And after that, we are now running on with the 26th or 27th batch of BHMS and probably 23rd batch of PG. If I'm not sure, I'm not connected directly. Kalyani sir, you might be having the update information. So almost over 2,000 plus alumni are there who had been, who was attached with NIH. But till date, we had been able to connect only around 600 to 700 of the alumni across the three WhatsApp groups and the Telegram group. So, requesting all the ex-student of NIH, who are watching this CME and will be watching the CME in the coming days, please come forward and link yourself with us and be a proud alumni of NIH. Over to you, Kalyani sir, to conclude the seminar, CME.
Thank you, Vidyut. Dear seniors, friends and juniors, all of us are really happy by this CME by which we are able to come closer after a very long period of our student life in NIH. We must try to continue it and with a glorious attempts. So further request that please ask your friends, classmates, all other who are not yet attached to Alumni Association, please get them attached in Alumni by WhatsApp, and please refer the names with phone numbers to us for new speakers of all the fields, any fields, any annual alumni. Try to make this CME successful and helpful. Thank you very much. Thank you all to inaugurator, moderator, he could not come, those two speakers, Vidyut and everybody, especially Orko. Thank you all the viewers for coming over here and enjoying this CME. Thank you and welcome for the next.
So thank you viewers for watching today's CME. I hope you have really enjoyed it. And thank you to all the panel members also for having me with you. And also some more interesting topics to be said about this YouTube stuffs. If you want to get a e-participation certificate form, please go check on the form link given in the description. And just you have to fill up some little details, and afterwards you may get your e-certificate via your mail. And if you have to answer some questions, which are basic questions related with our subject, and as a reference you can get it in any organon books or any Mathematica books. You can just check it on. And if you want e-participation certificate for today's CME, just click on the link in the description given below. It will be available till Monday night, 12 a.m. And afterwards, it will be turned off. The site will be down for another CME, and it will not open until the next CME is being scheduled. And one more thing, if you want to get updated on various updates on NIH and NIH alumni meet, just give us a like in our social media pages. Like, we are on Facebook, go like us over there, link is in the description. And also follow us on Instagram and Twitter, all the links are given in description. And so with this, I finally say, oh, and finally, please do subscribe for more CME like this. And also click on the notification bell in order to get updated while we schedule a new live stream. It may take a few days or so, but it will be scheduled on time. So thanks all, and thanks for watching. Give it a like and also share this with your other fellow mates. Thank you and a very good night.